I looked down through the hole we'd made in that roof and wondered why we'd bothered. All those miles across hilly roads carrying our cripple, just to hear him told, "Your sins are forgiven." If that's what he needed, couldn't we have said that? We could have cheered him up, said to him, "Look, everybody makes mistakes. You can put things right and just move on. Rebuild your life, rebuild everybody's lives." We could even have found him something to do, even sitting there useless in a chair, instead of just leaving him in the dark to get on with feeling miserable. I'm sure there was something we could have done. And now, we'd got to pay for this hole in the roof that we'd made. We'd got to make our peace with the Pharisees because we'd upset them by the way we'd come to an unlicensed preacher. Oh, all sorts of things we'd got to put right. And then, oh, then we saw the look in Jesus' eyes and we heard, "Pick up your bed and walk." So he did it. Wow. And the Pharisees still weren't pleased. Oh, they've got to be so careful, these religious people. If you've got to sign documents and give permission and say, yes, it's all official, and did he, how long had he not been able to walk? Oh, when you get into that sort of territory, there's no winning. Ah, oh, but Jesus knew what our friend needed. He's never looked back. And we've all learnt. It's not just the visible problems that weigh you down. You've got to look deeper, look into someone's eyes, look into someone's heart, see what's really the matter. And sometimes it takes a hole in our lives for people to help us.